My name's Orla, and I'm here today to choose my wedding dress. I started life as Steve, and then Orla came along, and Orla has given me a completely different lease of life that I never expected to have.
Hello, hello, hello! How excited am I about today?
Look at you!
You look amazing.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I'm very well, thank you.
Orla, I want to introduce you to gorgeous Bernie.
Hi, Bernie.
Who's our stylist today. So, first off, congratulations.
Thank you so
much. You're getting married.
I am. I can't believe it. Somebody wants me at last.
Oh, we all want you. You're way too fabulous not to be wanted. Do you want to introduce you to your girls?
I do. So, this is Amy S.
Hi. Hi, Amy S. How are you?
Good, thank
nice
you.
Nice to meet you.
This is Amy C.
Hello, Amy C. How are you? Nice and easy.
Exactly.
Two Amys. And why getting married in drag then? That's going to probably be, you know, my first question. Why not as Steve and why as Orla?
I think in society, we get told what we have to wear. And I love the fact that, you know, that we can mess it up.
Walking down the aisle as Orla is not a joke. Orla is so important to me, gives me so much confidence, enables me to show off my feminine side and to be something that I'm not usually as Steve.
Right then, Orla. This is the first dress. It is so beautiful.
Oh my God, yes, it
and
is.
And so gorgeous. This is all about you being completely on show. And I think that, you know, from a psychological point of view, I know Orla's getting married, but
yes.
Also Orla is a persona and a performer.
Yes.
Your wedding day, is it a stage and a performance, or is it a stage without a performance?
Yes.
We want Orla to look like herself. We don't need her to look like she's about to go out and perform, because this is a special day, this is a real day.
As Orla, there is a facade, if you like, a barrier that helps me to perform, and Steve doesn't have that. Steve is a lot more vulnerable.
Are you afraid that after today, you may decide that Steve might be walking down the aisle? Or am I planting something that you haven't really considered?
Yeah, you are, because I hadn't considered that at all.
I'm only asking that question is because there is such a beautiful vulnerability to Orla, to this right now, where you are genuinely way more nervous than I think you thought you were going to be.
Yeah. I think it's because I'm more exposed.
This is such a personal thing in my life. I think I was a bit naive coming into this, and all of a sudden I've got this beautiful wedding dress in front of me, and it's become very real. It is now actually happening.
She's so used to Orla being such a big entity because she's on stage, whereas this is real Orla. It's real life Orla.
There's huge. Wow.
You look miserable, Orla. You look terrible. You look like you're hating this.
I love it so much.
Your behaviour's changed slightly. It's almost as if I'm meeting a bit of Steve right now.
Yes.
Did you expect that to happen?
No, not at all. Okay. I expected Orla to be here the whole time.
I was very shy growing up. I remember hiding behind my mother's skirts. I suffer very badly from nerves. Very worried all the time about what people think. Orla completely changes that. She enables me to go out and do stuff that I wouldn't normally do, that Steve wouldn't normally do.
It's been quite emotional when I hear that.
It's making me emotional. It is a huge thing. You know, it isn't just Orla getting married, it is Steve as well.
Orla, let's spin you round to the Amys. So, Amy, my darling.
She's so pretty. I think this manages to be beautiful and overstated while also being classic. And I think that is because we are seeing some Steve in there as well.
Amy 2, my darling.
I don't know. I'm not as sold as Amy 1. I love the tighter versions of things because you can have the big hips and everything, and that is more Marilyn Monroe, which we love that silhouette as
exactly,
well.
Exactly, yeah.
So I'd love to see you in something like that as well.
How do we feel about this?
I am loving the mermaid. I absolutely adore a mermaid dress. That's one of my costumes, actually.
I instantaneously feel more Orla completely straight away.
Talk to me a little bit about what I'm doing this, about Dad.
He's never met Orla. He knows about Orla. He knows what I do.
And with Dad, then, are you nervous about him seeing you like this?
Yes and no. I am quite nervous because he has never seen me like this. But in the same respect, when I came out, he was so accepting of me. I mean, Derek is the first one of my partners that he remembers the name of, so...
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Because there's been so many of them. I can hear that sachet from here. So, Orla, how are we feeling? Because everything has slightly changed. I mean, like, the shoulders have come round now, the hands have gone the hips, the nose has gone 3 inches higher.
Yeah.
Is this all because of this dress?
It's all because of the dress. I am in love with this dress. Oh, my God. This dress gives me so much confidence. You were completely right. It's familiar to Orla, but it's still pushing that much further. I feel sexy, I feel stunning. Like I could stop traffic. You know, air traffic.
Let's spin you around. Let's find out what our lovely drag mothers think.
I knew you'd love it. I knew it.
You wanted the mermaid.
I did. I love it.
Amy won.
I mean, look at you. When you were facing that way, I just couldn't stop looking at your bum. You have got a cracking rear end in that. And I mean, so much so that that might be all anyone looks at for the whole day.
I'm good with that.
Ding, ding, ding.
Even though this is an absolutely stunning dress, is the personality of this dress right?
Right then. I believe I have the perfect combination between our two gowns. This is an overskirt that goes on top of that dress.
Oh.
So what you do get is two dresses for one. So should we get this dress on?
Oh, my God, yes. Yes, I can't wait.
I think this definitely is going to be a moment for Steve and Orla to go, this is us, this is who we are.
But just so I can get to the whole back of the dress, are you comfortable with taking the wig off?
Of course, yeah.
OK, so let's take her off. I think then we get to meet Steve as well,
yes,
don't we?
Yes, you do.
Hi, Steve. Nice to meet you. I'm Gok.
Hi.
God. I know your missus really well.
Today's been a huge revelation for both Steve and Orla.
That's got to feel like a relief, getting that wig
it
off.
It actually is. I don't think people realise how much work goes into drag.
That's what I've learned, actually, is that it's not a performance. Steve and Orla, they need to work together.
I'm still so stunned and excited. So much of Steve, so much of Orla. It's beautiful. It's absolutely stunning.
It's got everything.
It's got two trains. Two trains!
It's absolutely amazing.
You look like Elsa. You're a Disney princess whilst still being Orla and Steve. It's great.
You look absolutely stunning, and I think it's so lovely that we've got to know both of you today. I know you feel great, but I think there's one other person that we need to call.
My sister Anne has told me that I have to call her up to get her approval.
Hi, is that Anne?
Hi.
Hello, Anne, it's Gok here. So I'm going to spin this camera around now so you can see your brother stroke Orla. Are you ready for this?
Go. Oh my God. That's so beautiful.
So, do you think this could be the gown?
Definitely.
Okay, so I'm gonna leave you there. You stay here while I ask Orla, your brother, a very, very important question. Orla, Steve, are you saying yes to the dress?
Yes!